In this video, we will write a program in JavaScript that generates as many NFT profile pictures as you want. These profile pictures are a combination of different layers: a background layer, some kind of head or body layers, and accessories like hats, glasses, or of course, lasers. And every layer has a different probability. Laser eyes are rarer than squared shades, for example. And after that, we also generate the metadata for OpenSea. Let's do it! After setting up our project environment with npm init, we can move on to installing all the dependencies we need for our project. One of the dependencies we need is called Canvas. But in order to install Canvas, you might need some other dependencies on your system. On the GitHub page, there is a table. For each system, it gives you the instructions how to install all the different dependencies. I am on macOS, so I use Homebrew. I'd simply copy the line, put them into the terminal, and hit enter. And trust me, if you do this for the first time, get yourself a coffee. It will take some time. Now it's finally time to install our Node.js packages. We will use Canvas, Node Canvas, Merge Images, and Random.js to generate our NFT profile pictures. And for that, we need some layers. So I prepared some layers for us to combine in this folder here. As you can see, we will work with 6 different layers. We have a background layer, we have a layer for the eyes, facial hair, a head layer, a shirt layer, and a top layer, which we use for different hats and hairstyles. Each folder contains different graphics that we use as options for our different layers, which we will then randomly combine into our final NFT profile picture. All of these graphics are not done by me, but by my buddy Matt. These layers are from an NFT collection Matt and I started a while ago, and he gave me permission to use these beautiful graphics in my video here. Thanks again, Matt. And if you want to check out the NFT collection, it is called Hodel Hats, and you can find a link in the description down below. To start, we need an index.js file. We need some imports for merge images, node canvas, path, and the file system operations. I define a constant layer path, which holds the path to the folder we store the layers in. In order to see how merge images works, I do a little test. I define an array with 6 different layer images I want to combine. Each is stored inside the layer path, and I use path.join in order to append the subfolder and the file name to specify one layer each. Next, I use merge images with the layers array that I've just defined with the canvas object and the image object that I get from node canvas. And because all of this is an asynchronous operation, I use then to get the result value, and I log this to the console in order to see what we are working with. When I run our program now with node index.js, I see something cryptic. This is a data URL, and it can directly be used to be embedded inside an HTML page using an image tag. But that's not what we want. We want to have a PNG image, which we then can upload to OpenSea or IPFS. If we look closely at the data URL, we will see that we have 2 parts. First, we have some kind of data type discriminator, and after the comma, we have a base64 encoded data string. So here's what we can do. We define a function saveBase64Image, which takes the data URL and the file name to save to. Now we take the data URL and split it at the comma and take the second half, leaving us with the base64 encoded image. We then use the buffer object to decode the base64 encoded image data into bytes, and then we save them to a file. Now we have a way to save our data URLs to actual PNG files on the hard disk. Next, we build ourselves a merge layers and save function, which takes the layers and the output file to save to. It then uses merge images with the layers to merge them together and generate a data URL, which we now save using our save base64 image function. Now it's time to test our merge layers and save function, and we hand in the layers, we hand in the output path, we run the script, and voila, here it is, our first combined image. Okay, that was not that impressive. So let's start with some randomization. For that, we need some additional information on our layers. For instance, what layers are there? And in what order should they be combined? Most importantly,
What is the probability of getting laser eyes?
Inside our layers directory, we create a content.js module containing a JSON that will hold additional information about each layer and layer option. The top level element is called layers, and it's an array of objects. The order of the objects here defines the order in which the layers are combined. That's why we start with background. It has a probability of 1 to be part of the NFT, because we don't want to have any NFT without a background.
Well, duh.
Each layer object defines different options. Each option has also a name, a file to use when it's chosen, and a weight, which defines its relative probability. And we need to define this for each file in our background folder, and repeat that for each layer that we want to have in our NFT.
By the way, if you want to try this at home, you don't need to type all of this code seen here yourself. There is a link to a GitHub repository in the description down below.
The first thing we got to do is to add random.js to the requirements. We create ourselves a function randomly select layers. We hand in the location of our layer images and the layers JSON array. The first thing we need to do is to initialize our Mersenne twister.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
The Mersenne twister is by far the most widely used general purpose pseudo number generator. And you can call him RNGesus. We give ourselves two variables to store what's been chosen for us. After that, we iterate over each layer in our content JSON and let the number generator decide if this layer will be part of the final NFT. If it is, we select the option for this layer using a function called pickWeighted. In order to generate the OpenSea metadata later and to prevent duplicate generation of the same NFT, we want to save the option we chose for each layer. For that, we use an object in which we map each layer name to the chosen layer option. Lastly, we save the image path of the selected image to our images array and return the images and selected traits from our function.
Now we need to define pickWeighted. PickWeighted chooses an element out of a weighted distribution of elements. In a weighted distribution, an element with the weight of 2 is twice as likely to be chosen than an element with the weight of 1. But the question is, how do we implement this? To get a better understanding of the problem, let's start with an example.
We have 4 different layer options, and each option has an associated weight to it. Option 1 has a weight of 1, option 2 has a weight of 3, and option 3 and 4 have a weight of 2. So option 3 should be twice as likely to be chosen than option 1. If we lay out all the options on an axis next to each other, giving each option the amount of space according to its weight, we could just randomly pick a number between 0 and the sum of all weights and would get a randomly selected option. And because all options are using up the space in this area according to their weight value, the probability of choosing one of the options is bigger for options with a higher weight than it is for those with a smaller one. To code that, we hand in our RNG and the options to choose from. We add up all the weights to get the total weight value. After that, we get ourselves a random value between 0 and the sum of weights. Now we iterate over each element and see if the chosen random value is smaller than all currently visited weights combined. And if we find the range the value is in, we have found our randomly selected option, which we then return. Finally, let's generate some art. We put together a generator function, which takes the number of NFTs to generate, the path to the layers, and the output path to save our freshly generated NFTs to. We import the contents.js module for all the layer information we need. Now we just repeat the following steps until we have all the NFTs we want to generate. First, we get ourselves a random selection of layers, and then we merge and save them. We define ourselves an output path and call our generateNFTs function to generate 20 NFTs. Done. Let's run it. And here we are, 20 freshly generated NFTs at our disposal to upload to OpenSea. We have different hats, we have different beard styles, we have glasses and different shirts. Everything an NFT lover could ask for. So that's all good and fine. Although, as we can see here, some combinations just don't work out. But what if I told you that there is a way to add more rules to our layer selection to prevent this from happening at all? If you're interested in how to do that, please let me know in the comments below.
But there is one rule I want to enforce. I don't want to have any duplicates in my NFT collection. For that, we need to add a set of already generated layer combinations to our generator function. We can't just save a JavaScript object into a set. So we need to use the JSON module to generate a string out of the select traits object and put this into the set instead. So every time we have generated a new layer configuration, we check if we have already an identical configuration in our set. And if we have, we retry the process. And every time we generate a unique configuration, we will add this to our set to keep this configuration unique. And that's how we prevent duplicates. Let's run it for 100 NFTs and see what happens. As you can see, here and there a duplicate would have been generated. But our logic catched it and prevented that. You could now go ahead and upload all of these to OpenSea or any other marketplace and be done with your collection. But if you want to use your own smart contract and upload all of these images to your own web server or better to the IPFS, you will need to generate some metadata. The metadata OpenSea needs is basically a JSON. How this JSON should look like is described in OpenSea's developer documentation. We need 5 different fields. The name and the description are very self-explanatory. The external URL is a URL that's used for a button on the details page for your NFT. But now it gets interesting. Image. You might have guessed it, this field holds the URL to the image the NFT is connected to. But why don't we have a URL in here? That's because the URL is generated after you upload your generated image to your web server or the IPFS. So I added a placeholder here, which you can replace with the correct URL manually or better programmatically. Last but not least, we have the attributes. This is what OpenSea uses to build all the stats and categories for a collection. If you are on OpenSea, you basically can filter the collection by traits. So if you only want to see NFTs with laser eyes, there you go, only laser eyes. We extend our content object a little. We add a function that generates the skeleton for our metadata files. This function takes the token ID and the attributes and spits out all the fields for the JSON that are static for our collection. Next, we add a generate metadata function that takes our content object, the current token ID, and the selected traits for this NFT. This function transforms the layer configuration object that randomly select layers generate into the format that the metadata JSON needs for the attributes to be shown on OpenSea. So we iterate over each layer name option name pair and fill our attributes array with trait type and value pairs. And to get the full metadata JSON, we hand all this over to the metadata template function that we have just defined in our content object. All we have to do now is to extend our generate NFTs function to also save the metadata to our output directory. For that, we call our generate metadata function with the current token ID and the selected traits and save the resulting JSON to a file. Done. When we run our script again, we will find that there is now one JSON file for each image file in the output directory. In the JSON file, we see the name, the description, and the external URL, as well as the attributes. Looking at the attributes, we see that they pretty much match up with the NFT image shown on the right side. So we have a green background, we have a light skin colored hat, we have a shirt with flames on it, and the hodl hat is wearing 3D glasses on his eyes. If you want to see how I built my own NFT collection with a custom smart contract and a decentralized app in only 3 days, here's a video for you. Thanks to all of my patrons for supporting my work, and until then, have a lot of fun, coders.